So, as I was just saying, next match on court is men's doubles, our fifth and final semi-final. And it's the number one seeds, Kien Keat Koo and Boon Heong of Malaysia, up against the number four seeds from Japan, Hirokatsu, Hashimoto, and Noriyasu, Hirata. Well, there we can see in the bottom half of the draw, a surprise in the All Indonesian contest was the number of three seeds. Chandra and Kendra Gunawan were beaten by their teammates in three close games. So, Obama and Saputra already through to the final. So the number one seeds are the left and right-handed combination. The Malaysians, Kien Keat Koo and Boon Heong of Malaysia. And the other appearance here in India was at the World Championships 2 years ago in Hyderabad, where they won a bronze medal. Formed their partnership, the Malaysians, in 2006, and only their second tournament together. They won the gold medal at the Asian Games in Doha. So Kien Keat Koo is 25 years of age. The left-handed Boon Heong, 23. World ranking of four, down one place from last week when they were number three. They're the number one seeds, of course, and they've got a very good win-loss record for the year. Very positive. Five tournaments played. And reached the final of the All England. Both of their previous matches in two straight games, and that first match against the Indian pair won in just 19 minutes. And then yesterday in the quarterfinal, if you were with us, we enjoyed watching that one against the number five seeds Cho and Kwon from Korea. So their opponents, the number four seeds, Japan, Hirokatsu, Hashimoto, and Noriyasu, Hirata. Hashimoto, 25, his partner a couple of years older. World ranking of 10, seeded 4. And they, like their opponents, have the same win-loss record for the year. The Japanese pair, we know, are in great form because they reached the final of the Asian Badminton Championships last week in Chengdu. And all the finalists, in 10 of them, one of the only non-Chinese contingent. In fact, just to emphasize China's dominance in those Asian Badminton Championships, 16 out of the 20 semi-finals were all Chinese affairs. Anyway, this is the third meeting between these two pairs. Last meeting was last year at the quarterfinal stage of the Indonesia Super Series event, won in three games, as you can see, by the Japanese pair. Mark Spate, Mark from Germany, Mr. Charlotte, and the service judge.
Gentlemen, on my right, Koo Kun Keats, Tan Byung Hong, Malaysia. And on my left, Hirokatsu Hashimoto, Noriyasu Hirata, Japan. Koo Kun Keats serve, Noriyasu Hirata, level, play.
So the number one seeds from Malaysia, nearest to us, Kien Keat and Tan Boon Heong. Against number four seeds, Hashimoto and Hirata.
Service over. One,
all. A couple of silver medals last year at the World Championships where they lost out to Kong Yun and Fu Haifeng.
Service over.
A silver medal at the Asian Games in Guangzhou. And what a match that was against the Olympic champions Marcus Guido and Hendra Setiawan. In fact, they held two match points in the second game before losing in three games.
Service
an
over.
Absolute thriller.
Two, all. Service over. Three, all.
All in the finals as well this year, the Malaysians. Lost in the final in three games to Matthias Bo and Carsten Morgensen. Oh, that's a great shot from Tan Boon Heong.
Four, three.
Forehand defense. Drives it down the line. An area of his game which I was highly critical of two or three years ago. Thought he looked awkward at the net, but he's worked on that and he's greatly improved. Some very fast and furious. Trying a change of pace there, Hashimoto. Start to their partnership in their first full year playing together, which was 2007. Each seven finals,
service over,
winning six of them.
4-7.
Yet to win a title so far this year.
Service over,
8-4. No, it's too long.
Service over, 5-8.
Flat exchanges.
Service over, 9-5.
Yes, and as he loves to do, Koo Kien Keat gradually making his way forward to the net.
Service over, 6-9.
too flat. On the wrong of the back line.
Cut. 7,
well, I was
9.
Saying they were playing well last week. Reached the final of the Asian Badminton Championships, and just to emphasise how well they were playing, they beat the reigning Olympic champions in the quarterfinal, Kido and Setia won this Japanese pair.
8-9.
Oh, dear me. Oh, you won't hit many shuttles with that, young man.
Service over. 10-8. Service fault called.
Service fault called. Well, haven't seen that for years.
Football.
Moving his feet. Goodness gracious. And really standing on the line.
Tell you.
Well, Koo appealing to the umpire, Mark Spate of Germany.
10.
To say that's absolutely extraordinary. Very, very rarely do you ever see a footfall called.
Service over. 11-9 interval.
Well, the Malaysians do have the advantage at the mid-game interval. 2-point advantage to be precise. Tan Kim Ha and Park Jubon, respective coaches. Park working in Japan now. Did have a spell in England, then went to Malaysia, and then Japan. Either way, he's been, he's made a huge influence. Interesting that a Malaysian coach, former international player himself, Tan Kim Ha, had a spell in England as well.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Turn on the left as
11,
we look at them. 9. Coach, both these sets of coaches, wonderful influence on their players.
Service over. 10, 11.
These pair are doing very well
all.
About cutting out Koo Kien Keat for an awful lot of the rally. And then when he does get involved, he feels he's got to do something special because he hasn't hit many shuttles.
Now,
back into 12, the lead, the Japanese pair.
11.
Had since 2-1 up. It's all too much for some. Lads having his afternoon nap.
14-11.
Oh, this is wrong. 5 straight points. 5 points since the mid-game interval. Only 6 points since the mid-game interval in favour of the Japanese pair.
15-11.
Oh, I wonder what on earth Park Jubon said to them. Whatever it was, it's had the desired effect.
Oh.
8 straight points.
17.
Good flick serve.
11.
And then good placement on the smash. Finally, the run comes to an end.
Service over. 12-17.
There's a little hand signal. And what does that mean? Serving out wide, obviously. Oh, that was going wide. Hesitation from Hirata.
13-17.
Yeah, that was going wide. Short rallies, so often see this in men's doubles. Comparison
14,
to the women's doubles we've
17.
Just witnessed. Since the mid-game interval.
19-14.
It's been a one-way traffic. 10 of the last 13 points. Japanese pairs way.
Service over. 15-19.
So sharp
20,
around the net, even when they appear to be under pressure, driving the shuttle back down the line, and now 5 game points.
Service over. 16-20.
It's going wide.
Game.
And on their second opportunity, the number 4 seeds convert. 21-16.
Noriyasu Hirata, 21-16.
Well, from the mid-game interval, when they were 9-11 down, suddenly Hashimoto and Hirata sprang into action. And that's the result of it, 21-16 in just 12 minutes of play. This always fascinates me when two coaches come onto court to talk to a doubles pair, but talk to the players individually. Ron Clark, Duval. I'm pretty happy with the way his players reacted to the second half of that opening game.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Second game. Level. Play.
So having taken the opening game from 16 in just 12 minutes of play, the number 4 seeds are becoming the number 1 seeds from Malaysia. Time for the former world number 1s to react.
Yeah. Service over. 1-1.
Tremendous. What a delightful change of pace from Hirata.
2-1. Service over. 2-2.
Oh, that's lovely again. Those little directed shots.
Four,
thinking about
two.
The placement, guiding it into the open space.
Service over. 3-4.
Just long.
Service over. 5-3.
Hits on the return of serve. The Japanese pair are growing in confidence all the time. Hirata on his defensive play, the little block steering the shuttle, and that immediately turned the Japanese defensive play into attack. There was the block, forced the Malaysians to lift the shuttle,
seven,
and therefore the opportunity
three.
To then hit the smash themselves. Since the early stages, Kuki and Kiat coming forward to the net, dominating, hunting the shuttle. Determination
seven.
To Koo. It's a good run of points by the number one seeds. Points the deficit to just
seven.
One solitary point. Up because he'd broken the strings in his racket.
Service over. 8.
That's when the strings
six.
Went. Yeah, but that's clever. Didn't try and do too much, just thought about the placement.
Service
is signaling an intent.
7-8.
Level the Malaysians.
8-8.
Japanese players and the way they think about the placement of the shuttle. Mixing the pace, these little half court pushes, that was just delightful.
9-8.
Just when you watch this Japanese player last year when they won the Dutch Grand Prix event. Two titles last year, also one in Osaka. 18 semi-finals at two Super Series events last year, and that really was signaling their ability and their potential. Since then, they've got better and better.
Bolt. Service over, 9-9.
Well, have a two-point advantage as they did in the opening game at mid-game interval. But the Malaysians couldn't convert that into the opening game. Somehow they had to keep the momentum going here in the second.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
As far as the Malaysians are concerned, they'll have very happy memories of this Siri Fort Arena. This is where they won their Commonwealth Games gold medal. And in fact, the man you're looking at, Kien Keat, won three gold medals at last year's Commonwealth Games. On the men's doubles, the team event, and the mixed doubles as well, the mixed with Chin Yi Hui. Side of the court. Suddenly comes out with something extraordinary. And that's what makes him such an exciting player to watch.
14,
and so difficult 11. To play against, because where on earth did that come from? Opponents weren't expecting that at all. Absolutely brilliant. Not only the execution of the shot, but the awareness that that's where the gap was.
Service over. 12-14.
Had his injury problems at the beginning of the year. Did Koo. He and his partner withdrew during the group stages of the Super Series finals in January. Speed. And in the end, the Japanese players left
16,
stranded.
12.
And the reason is now broken up on a 4-point cushion. Gap towards the line judge.
Over, 13,
I have to say, I'm not
16.
Convinced by that. Yeah, that was clearly another good call by the line judge. Oh, my word. That's extraordinary. Power and placement.
Service over.
And an angle.
17, 13.
Shots.
15,
that was good defense.
17.
Two points in it. Oh, clever. There's the drop shot, the change of pace from Hirata. That was the one that did the damage. Forced the short lift, he was able to
17.
Follow forward. Freed up his partner to rotate back out. Oh, the losing coach is looking a little bit anxious in their seats. As well they might. Because the 4-point advantage that they had has been closed. It's now all level. 17 all. needs to try out the new racket. Hashimoto. Saw a great run of points, second half of the opening game.
18-17.
Oh, we're going to see the same game here. They were 13-17 down, remember? So now five straight points to take them into the lead. Right, that's six straight points. Malaysians, oh, they have a habit of doing this. They just lose their focus.
17.
2 points away from the place into the Irish final. Great defense. Unbelievable. From Hirata. Man of the match in my book.
20 match points.
That's 17. Seven straight points from 13-17 down. Now three match points for the number four seeds from Japan. Oh, more strings gone. Hashimoto's racket.
Sarasova, 18-20.
Oh, the Malaysians being handed a lifeline. Still match points, of course, for the Japanese pair. Did he get that back?
19-20.
Well, two match points have been brilliantly saved. One more match point remains in favour of the Japanese pair. Hirokatsu Hashimoto and Noriyasu Hirata have overcome the number one seeds Kien Keat Koo and Tan Boon Heong in two straight games, 21-16, 21-19, and 34 minutes
of play. Noriyasu Hirata, 21-16, 21-19.
Thank you. Well, what a match by the Japanese pair. From 9-11 down in the opening game, they storm through to take the first, 21-16 in the second. They were 13-17 down before winning seven straight points to take them to match points, and they converted finally. This, the moment of victory, when they converted their third match point opportunity, and they are safely through to the final tomorrow. Oh, they really are in great form. Second final in 2 weeks for the Japanese combination. So that's what we've seen today, our semi-finals day here from the Yonex Sunrise India Open. Started with men's singles and Peter Gaidar safely through. It's surprising that all of our semi-finals in straight games. Then mixed doubles and the Indonesians prevailed. Women's singles and the very exciting youngster from Thailand, Borana Prasoksuk, coming through against the number four seed in the end. Then women's doubles and the number one seed safely through, but the number one seeds in the men's doubles couldn't make it because they were beaten by the Japanese number four seeds Hashimoto and Hirata. Of course, that concludes our semi-finals for today. Five finals for you tomorrow. We, of course, will be back here for semi-finals action. All five finals tomorrow, starting at 1400 local time, 2 p.m. in the afternoon. So, from all of us here in Delhi, hope you've enjoyed semi-finals day. Do join us tomorrow for the finals. And until then, from all of us here, bye-bye.